Hey guys, Sukhshop here with another live game commentary brought to you from our Unranked to Diamond series. Today we're playing as Shaco Jungle. We're currently at around high gold elo. We're almost in our promos, actually, up into gold 1, I believe it is. So yeah, today we're just playing on Shaco, and hopefully I'll be able to teach you guys some things about how to play Shaco and how to play the jungle and all that lovely business. Now, I'm not quite sure how I'm going to play Shaco this game, because looking at the new team, they've got Karma, they've got Lulu, they've got Volibear, like, even Ez, like, these aren't really easy targets for me to go for, not easy targets for me to assassinate, so I might go for more of a split push build this game, and, you know, we'll see what I do, we'll see, you know, if you're watching this video, I would have already made my mind up, and I would have titled the video something appropriately if I do something special, and if not, then, well, we'll just, you know, it's a surprise. So yeah, Runes and Masteries guys, AD res, attack speed, quince, army yellows, whatever blues you want to go. Masteries go 12-18-0 with Thunderlord's Decree. Helps with your burst for ganking, and also just the cunning tree in general is quite nice. Just pretty good runes setup, honestly. Now this is so this is what you want to do when you're clearing on Shaco, is you just want to start a buff, stack boxes on it, and then go and invade. That's what I like to do on Shaco. This is the route that I like to run. Now, because it's Volibear, I can't really fight him, you know, if I invade him, because Volibear is not a champion that actually takes damage when he's clearing. So, you know, I won't really be able to get in on Volibear. But, you know, I put some boxes down, and then I put another box after the camp has spawned. I'm going to smite this away here, and then just take this down. I'm going to get my Q, and I'm going to try and take away his blue buff. Now, hopefully I get here in time. If Volibear is smart enough, if he's smart enough to realize that, okay, I'm against a Shaco, I might have to be careful about positioning, you know, my jungle route. Basically, I might have to be careful about my jungle route because he might try and steal. Then he would either start at this buff, or he would be here to kind of contest it around this time. If he's not respecting me here, then he's not going to be here. Either way, it's a fairly somewhat risk-free strategy, because, you know, and as you can see here, I get away with it. So I do recommend to invade on Shaco a fair amount. He's pretty good at invading. Against this particular matchup, against the Volibear, it is a little difficult for me to actually fight Volibear. Like I said, he's very tanky, doesn't tend to take that much damage, so I can't really prey on him. And he actually has pretty good sustained damage as well. I'm going to smite this for the Wolf Spirit here. So it is hard for me to get Volibear in a 1v1 fight, but you don't actually have to bully the enemy jungler that much if you want to invade him. You can just be opportunistic about when you're invading and go for it that way, which is what I'm doing this game. Now, what I'm going to be doing here is I'm going to go for a level 3 gank. I'm choosing to go topside, although we do have a Soraka top for some reason, and Soraka top doesn't really strike me as someone that's easy to gank for, but I'm going to try to go for it anyway. So here we go. Hopefully that fear gets her before she flashes, but that's fine. E plus ignite is going to finish her off, easy peasy. Let's help her push this wave in here, although it may be a bit unnecessary to help her push it in because Lulu does have teleport. So Lulu will be getting back in here pretty soon. But I don't need to take the CS, I just want to take the experience really. So I'm just going to get that XP, and now I'm going to go to mid here and try and fight Azir. Volibear is on his Gromp, so he's going to be a little bit disposed right now. He's not going to be here in time to fight us with the Azir. This was a bit early. I thought Azir might have gone to face check that bush there. Nice silence, perfect stuff, and then we get a good kill. So it is easier to gank people when they do have good CC to set it up with. I think Shad might be trying to escape the green screen. Shad, are you trying to get out of the bed? Are you trying to get out, Shad? Listen, Shad, if you're trying to get out, you should come this way. Hello, hello, Shad. This way. You coming out, Shad? You coming out? What are you doing? Okay, well, he needs to make his mind up either way. Come on, Shad, you can do it. I'm going to take my blue buff here. I want to secure this just because, you know, Volibear, you know, if I've taken his blue, he might go for my blue, and I don't want him to do that. I'd rather keep my blue buff, thank you very much. So I'm just going to take this away. I'll smite it, just so I take it fast, and I can recall here as well. I've got a decent amount of gold, so I am going to be recalling kind of quickly. And here we go. Let's go for the Grump here. I might try something cheeky in mid here. I know Cho'Gath recalled, but I might try and just get some good harass off onto this Azir. Like, if I just show up on him, I can just do a bit of damage to him. But I'll be level 5, I can just harass him. Well, Cho'Gath is actually recalling back into lane. So as long as Cho'Gath doesn't push this here, I can get in and we can might actually be able to get Azir again. We'll see. So let's go and see what's going on here. Blitz is on his way. I don't know whether we're gonna need him. The more the merrier, though. This guy also didn't use his flash in the previous gank, so this is very. Oh, Cho'Gath made that very obvious, but still, that's fine, I guess. Although a flash for a flash is, you know, it could be better, but it's all good. I'm actually gonna recall now because I do need to get some items, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna go for the red smite this game, and I'm gonna go for warrior enchant. So we'll go red smite and then get that and some boots. Double Dorans and boots. I'm going red smite because I want to be able to 1v1 people a bit better. If I'm going for a split push build, which I might do this game, then it is quite important for me to be able to 1v1 people, and Scumptious Saber helps me do that. Blue smite is a decent option on Shaco as well, because blue smite enables you to just run at people, but you can't go wrong with red smite. And yeah, so I'm actually going to be invading here because, you know, I want to keep up the pressure as Shaco. I don't know if he. I don't know if he thinks I saw him there. He may have done. All right, nice. So the reason why I wanted to invade him wasn't just because I'm Shaco, but because our mid laner is actually winning pretty hard. So our mid lane should be able to do some stuff. Is she gonna ambulance that Bolibear? Yes, she is. All right. So because our mid laner is winning, which means that it's because we've ganked him twice now. It means that it's easy for this. Oh, can we get up here? It's easy for this, like, if I end up fighting someone. Oh, good polymorph, not good enough though. So yeah, eventually I'll get the point out I'm trying to make here. If it came to a fight, then, like, if people were collapsing, Azir was a bit too low to help his Volibear, but Cho'Gath was full health. He also had a whole level ahead of Azir as well, he was level 6, so Azir wouldn't be able to help as much as Volibear would be able to, as Cho'Gath would be able to help if it came down to it. Now their blue buff is spawning in 30 seconds. I kind of want to get there like right away. I don't know if I can get this red buff first. I'm going to try and do this red buff first. This may not work out for me though. Alright, Volibear's going bot anyway. He's not going to be able to contest his blue here. Now as we can see actually, he did his red buff slower than I did his blue. So I don't know how he managed to do that. Did he might have gone Krug's chickens red or something. But yeah, he did a really strange path there, which didn't really help him. And now he's going to lose his... He's going to lose his blue buff because of this as well, which is going to be good. Taking blue buff away from Azir is going to be nice, as well as just the fact that I get to take it for myself, which is good because I'm greedy as hell. Let's take this down. I want to look towards doing objectives on Shaco as well. Whenever you're ahead as the jungler, especially someone like Shaco who is very good at taking objectives, then you do want to be looking to try and take them where you can. And I'm in a position now where I can look to do that where I want to. So Rift Herald is something I'm looking for, and so is Dragon. It's a mountain dragon, so it's not the best one around, but it's still good. I'm smiting this quite early. I guess it's slightly risky to do that, but I quite like having this wolf spirit to tell me if someone's going to come in for me here. I'm actually going to leave a mini one up, though. He should be screwed there. Oh, nice. Nice escape. I should be able to finish him off instead. I'm sorry. Are you serious? 30 health. Well, that's a shame. I was a bit out of range from Ignite as well, because I was pressing Ignite, but it didn't go off, so I wasn't quite close enough. That was unfortunate, but still. We can go for this Rift Herald here, though. If someone comes for it, we can definitely do this. And I don't know about going for Lulu. She's trying to set up a freeze, so I might be able to sneak into the lane bush here and try and lane gank against Lulu. And I don't know where she's got it warded in the river, if she does at all. If she does have it warded, then she may have just seen me there, but I might still be able to sneak in here and do something. Now this guy's a little too far to his tower for us to actually be able to reliably kill him, but we should still be able to do some damage to him, get some stuff going. This may be a bit of a waste of time though actually. We'll see. I might just have to recall here instead. I'm setting up traps though just in case, you know, just boxes are always good. Wait, don't do it too obviously mate, it's fine. She'll come up closer. Alright, I'm actually going to recall on the tip of here. So, I just wanted to kind of scare off there because I decided, you know what, I'm not going to go for this. So I'm just going to press E on him and run away. This is slightly risky because I could have lost my blue buff here. But I don't think Volibear will do that. Volibear doesn't seem to be a jungler who's caring too much about his own, like, buff control. But if he's smart, he will know that my blue buff is most likely up now and that he would use this opportunity to try and take it. He's not going to do that, so he's not... Instead, he's going to actually stay behind here as far as like levels and stuff go. But I'm just going to be running bot here. seeing if I can do something to Ez and Karma. Ez Karma is actually a really good bot lane combination now, so I'm going to try and do something here. Don't know if it's pinked in this bush. It's not. It's always a bit of a risky one to deceive into that bush because it's quite a common pink spot. Got a red smiter. Going to try and position myself in between this Ez here and the Blitzcrank so that he can't just freely Q our Blitz. Oh shit. Not like this. I'm dead. Fuck. Was that... I don't think it would have been a flash there. Did he flash? Maybe he just ran at me. I did get slowed, I think. Either way, that was a bit too greedy by me there. That was a 2-for-2 in the end. Not too bad, considering we also got a teleport out of it. But Soraka did TP too. So 2-for-2, not what we're looking for when we're the ones ahead in this game. So that wasn't very good for us. But still, it's not the end of the world by any means either. But now I'm level 7 here and I've got some items. I'm actually going to be looking to do this dragon here. Once you're level 6, taking objectives is a little easier because you can use your ultimate, your clone to help you. But I'm looking at like the kill scores this game, and I have pretty much the vast majority of our kills, which is what, you know, what Shaco does best is killing people, right? So it's not that bad, but I also do want to try and get my teammates fed a little bit so it's not all just on me to carry, because Shaco doesn't really carry very well. Considering I'm this fed though, I might just go for an assassin build. I know I said that I was going to go for like a split push thing, but if I'm really far ahead in the game, then taking an assassin build is something you can't really go wrong with. So I'll go for an assassin build this game, I think. Might be able to get some damage onto this Ez here, actually. I don't think Karma's around just yet. Don't think she is, at least. She might be, but I'm not sure. I'll save my E for after he's used his jump. Alright, that's his heal. Don't think I'm going to be able to keep chasing. If I had red buff, I could keep chasing him, but without red, just going to get his summoners or his heal. Then run away. So what I'm going to do here is we're going to go and transition this into a dragon play. Because we harassed the... We got the enemy AD carry low. So he's going to recall. He's not going to be here to contest this, which makes it a lot easier for us to take this away. I don't even want to use my ult here, but I'm going to do it anyway. I feel like I don't need to use my ult here, but I'm going to do it. Because it does make things a lot easier if you've got your ult. I don't want to tank this though. Because my clone isn't going to die that fast. And it's probably going to expire. Oh shit. What the fuck? Alright, well at least I got it, I guess. Okay. Holy shit. I had a pink ward up the whole time as well. I didn't put it down. I thought we had it. But they double flash. So flash, volley, karma. And I still got it. So that's not bad. I probably should have communicated with Blitz more tonight. Not to leave me there. Although that wasn't really the end of the world. If I was someone that wasn't Shaco, that would have been pretty bad for us. But, you know, because I would have... If I was playing someone that wasn't Shaco, then I would have taken so much damage from that dragon that they flashed over and I probably would have died instantly. And if I wasn't Shaco, I don't think Blitz would have left me if I was playing a different champion, because he would have recognized, actually, he needs my help here. But still, two flashes and dragon just for me dying, considering dragon alone is worth a death, I think that's not that bad, honestly. Oh shit, they've already taken it. Is this warded or what? Come on, Blitz, you can do it. You can do it, I believe. Oh god. Alright, so they were actually really fast on getting this blue, which is good. For them. Not for me, but for them. They realised that I was actually taking this... Like, I was kind of just... Yeah, just getting that blue too easily. And so they decided to secure it. Rather than him doing his standard path, which was his red into his blue, they do it first, which is cool. And Volibear almost died there. If he wasn't playing Volibear with his silly little passive and being very tanky, then he would have definitely died there. So that's good. Karma's around mid though, I can see. Like this Blitzcrank's roaming a lot and Karma is answering that, which is kind of good, I guess. Like I think it's kind of what Karma has to do. She has to answer these plays, but at the same time, Karma isn't really as good at roaming as Blitzcrank is, so it's not really working out for them too well. Nice, I got him. So I didn't mention about my item build too much here. Outside of the fact that I've gone Warrior Enchant and Skirmishes is obvious, somewhat obvious at least. You can go whatever the Bloodraiser if you want to. You can. Wouldn't really recommend it because you don't really need it. Okay, they're not taking this bait because they're not actually chasing me. You don't really need the attack speed, and it's actually a lot of the time it's better just to have the AD. I guess you can go Bloodraiser. I don't like it though. I really don't like it. But yeah. But Moby Boots, which is what I want to talk about here. Moby Boots is the big pickup here. The reason why I like Moby Boots on Shaco is because, like, Moby Boots are honestly underrated because Swifties have been so good this season that everyone's just forgotten about Mobies. Which is, like, unnecessary, honestly. Like, Mobies are still really good. Ah, shit. I was going to get that guy. And the reason I really like Mobies I like them on Blitzkrieg as well. The reason why I really like them on Shaco is because anyone who has a stealth, if you're moving really fast, then you actually kind of extend the power of that stealth, if that makes sense. So, especially like a limited stealth, yeah? So, if I appear out of nowhere, if I go invisible, if I'm moving faster, then it's almost like my stealth lasts longer because I travel more distance with it. So, I really like that, at least. Now, Azir is still up here somewhere. I think they know I'm here. So I'm just going to harass him with my E. Max your E, by the way, first on Shaco, because it is your highest burst damage ability. It may seem weird, because it's like a spell, and you think you do auto-attack damage on Shaco. But your other abilities, maxing them doesn't really help you that much. You can max your Q if you... Well, no, don't max your Q first. Because maxing Q... putting points in your Q only increases, like, a percentage of your damage, and if you're not doing that much damage, because you do like 100 damage, like with an auto attack, then you're improving your deceive will make it do like 110. But if you max it later on into the game, then actually it kind of scales better with levels than it does with items and like how far you are into the game than it does with skill levels. If there's just three people here, we can try something here, but it's going to be pretty difficult. Shaco isn't someone who wants a team fight, so I'm gonna put pink here. Is it warded? It was warded. Alright, they're all around though, like more or less all around, so we do have to be quite cheeky if we want to do something here. And I am positioning myself quite cheekily. You definitely can't just like up front fight people on Shaco, like a whole team. Do we really want to go for that guy though? I thought we were collapsing around here. That would have been so good, but we just ran away. That was... Alright. I don't know why we did that, honestly. That was... kind of ruined the plan I had there. But still, I might be able to sneak in again here. We can't dive, but we might be able to get a blitz grab onto someone. The blue buff's about to respawn too. Let's just put some traps down. I'll go bot instead here. Cloud Dragon is spawning next, which is like the worst one. It's not one I care about, at least. Okay, I don't think Azir realized I was there. I could have probably killed him then, just running at him. Nice. Now, I used my ult before I went in here because I actually... I did 50% of what I wanted to do and then 50% just mucking up. So I used my ult first because if you use your ult before you go in, then what you can do if you, like, if you go far away... Oh, that cheeky double kill. If you go far away, then because your ult is kind of, it travels with you based on distance. Like, if it goes too far away, it'll just snap back to you. It's the easiest way to get your clone in a fight without having to waste time in the animation of your clone appearing. So what I mean by that is that if I press R in a fight, because I want my clone out, then it's going to take, like, a second or so for my clone to actually appear. All that time I'm standing still, I'm wasting time. Whereas if I use R beforehand and then run it away from me and then like jump into the fight, then it will snap back to me and it will appear immediately, like removing that cast time. You don't want to do that all the time, obviously, because a lot of the stuff about using your ulti is actually avoiding certain skills, certain damage, like especially if it's abilities that kind of, like skill shots, for example, you can dodge with your ulti. You can actually dodge Karth Assault as well. Like you actually disappear for a very like short time, so you can actually dodge everything with Shacklehold if you're good enough with it. I haven't actually recalled in so long here, because I'm so indecisive about what I want to buy. I might go. I'm just gonna go for the split push build, I think. Or I don't know. We'll see. I should have waited for Moby Boots to pop. Oh my goodness. Oh my god, Blitz, you're a god. Holy shit. Yo, this Blitz doesn't waste time, man. You see that? Holy crap. I should probably get Hexdrinker this game. I got like a semi-tank build. We'll go for Dragon here as well. The reason why I wasn't focusing on this Dragon before and like soloing it is because it's a Cloud Dragon, which means I don't really give a shit about the Cloud Dragon. I would rather just be around my team doing stuff than actually going for this Dragon, because it's really crap. It's like so... It just doesn't really give you much. The benefit is really, really minor. Is that another Cloud Dragon coming as well next? Alright. Basically, it's not worth dedicating time for. You only just get it to, like, get it out of the way and, like, try and get another one spawning. That kind of stuff. It's not really that important by itself. Now, I want to recall here, and I'm going to buy my items. So the next item I'm going to buy here is going to be a Titanic Hydra. I know that sounds weird, but I am actually going to get a Titanic Hydra. Yes, there we go. I've actually bought it. Let's go for Hexdrinker next and upgrade my sweeper here. So this is going to be a semi-tank build, which is a good split push build. Tank builds aren't good for split pushing by themselves, because like tank builds don't give you damage, and to split push effectively you do want damage, because else you're going to be pushing really slowly and it's going to be pointless. Excuse me, but Titanic Hydra by itself is a very good split pushing item because of the cleave, like this. Like, it makes you push waves quite fast, which is something Shaco by himself is actually pretty bad at, killing minion waves. Stack Shiv is somewhat similar, it's alright at it. But also, it allows me to play more diverse Shaco. It means that I can kind of do what I want to do with this Titanic Hydra. Because I can still assassinate people with this item, it still gives me decent damage. It's just that it allows me to... I'm keeping my eye on the minimap here, I don't want to get collapsed on. But it looks like if I get collapsed on here, it's going to be from in front of me, which means I can just run away. I could have used my ult here, but I didn't. I actually thought I wasn't going to get much damage onto this tower at all. I'm not going to jump in on that because Lulu has stealth reveal, so she'd know I would be there, and I don't know where enough of her allies are to make that play too aggressive. But yeah. So if I'm tanky, like I can, it means it's harder for me to just die. It's harder for me to just blow up. So it's easier for me to play Shaco if I'm somewhat tanky. Now, obviously, don't want to be full tank because that just like defeats the purpose of even playing Shaco. But wow, she actually hit me with that. All right. Oh, this girl's gonna tether me. That was really unfortunate as I jumped in, but we get mid tower, which is fine. This is kind of the art of split pushing: is you want to apply pressure on side lanes, forcing attention to you so your team can do stuff on the other side of the map. However, having said that, I'm not going to try and pretend like I played that very well, because that was like, it was a bit unfortunate. I jumped in as soon as Karma appeared out. Like, I don't know why Karma's standing here just randomly when my team is pushing mid, but whatever. I think it's just like unfortunate timing, but what I did was fine, but I didn't want to die. It was okay, everything was alright, I just shouldn't die. Like, what happened there with Karma coming up for me is what should happen, and my team getting mid is what should happen as well, but my team was pretty much doing mid by themselves anyway. They didn't need me for that. And like I say, also, me dying is just like, that's the worst thing. Like, if you're split pushing and you die, like, what happened there is worth it, but I still need to avoid the deaths. It's still something that isn't, you know, it's not a particularly well executed split push, let's just put it that way. I know there's a ward in this side bush here. You go, bot. What's VT? Alright, well, I'll let her get some of this farm, because she'll probably rage if I don't. But we really shouldn't be showing at the same place. Like, our AD carry and our split pusher shouldn't really be pushing the same positions, because it's just a bit of a waste. Like, now we've got two people in one side lane, which is just a bit pointless, and it's like, I already carry doesn't want to be split pushing anyway. Like, like right now we should have role reversal. It should be Tristana in mid. Nice, let's flash and heal. Like, for example, I could use my ult there to block the tether from Karma. Holy shit, did she just jump that? I think she got her jump blocked by Wally Bear's Q. That's unfortunate. Alright, it's Wally's flash. I positioned my ult really preemptively there. Sorry, not my ult, my box. Nice. Cheeky play right here. Cheeky play right here. Can we dive this guy? Okay, not with that TP coming through. Ult? Has he got his ult? No. He almost has his ult. I'm going to put a box down so they can't chase us here. And so it will fear people chasing us. Oh my goodness, did she just give me away really hard there? No, she didn't. Alright. Okay, like Azir went in trying to make a play on the enemy team and then realized I was behind him and just like pushed soldiers into me. Alright, that's cool. We'll go for more memories here. I might go for Triforce next. Go for this crazy Shaco build. Maybe that'll be the title of the video. Crazy Shaco build. Stupid Englishman plays crazy Shaco build. That would be better if it was like a newspaper. It's too long for a YouTube video. A better title for the YouTube video would be something like, you know, most crazy OP Englishman you'll ever see. Top 5 builds for OP Shaco builds. Korean penis. Something like that would be the best, you know, would be the best title for a YouTube video. I can say stuff like that, by the way, because we're getting on to like 25 minutes, 30 minutes of this game. And no one watches this far. So, you know, I can say that stuff and I get away with it because there's no one here to punish me for it. So, you know, it's whatever, really. Let me push out mid here and I'll go for Dragon afterwards. So it's another air dragon. I don't give a shit about it, but I'm going to take it just so we can get a good dragon coming through soon. See, I am going to go for Triforce here. Triforce is actually a really good item by itself. It's really strong right now. What's my ult cooldown? 81 seconds at this level? That's pretty good. I don't actually have any attack speed, which does make it a little bit hard for me to play. I think I would like some attack speed in my build, which is, you know, I'm going to be getting it from Triforce, so that's fine. Next one. Are you serious? 3 air dragons in a row? What have I done to deserve this? Is it because I said the word penis? Is that why? Am I being punished for my penis? It's not how it goes. Alright, I'm going to bait my team really hard here. Because there's not much I can do by myself there anyway. Alright, so I'm going to do my ult trick here. Where I leave my ult really far back. There's the assassination. I'm going to run my ult through first. Okay, apparently I can't kill pink wards with my clone. Okay, this is really awkward. They all just waited for me there. I'm in trouble, boys. I'm in trouble. I played that really questionably. To be fair, I was very greedy there, wasn't I? I was very greedy there. Crap. Be careful, boys. Is he Dunzo as well? He should be Dunzo. He's Dunzo. Alright, let's go for our Phage here. And then we'll sell this and get... I'm going to go for the Stinger next because I really want the... I do want the attack speed here. Say at Blitz. Catch HT4. Is this guy French or what? Okay, his name is Cornichon. I don't know what Nichon means. Doesn't Nichon mean like nipple or something? I think Nichon means nipple. I'm pretty sure Cornichon means something nipple. I'm not sure about that. I'm pretty sure that means nipple in French. I seem to remember learning certain chat lines and Nichon being in it, so it probably means nipple. Or something along those lines, at least. You know, I learned lots of chat lines in French. They're all terrible, but because if you say things in a cheeky way, which I'm quite good at doing, then you get away with anything. Because if you can make someone laugh, you can say anything you want to them, and it always works. Unless, you know, it doesn't work, then it doesn't work. But most of the time, you don't have to worry about that. I wonder if he saw me there. I think he may have seen me there, actually. Well, his soldiers... I saw his soldiers... Do his soldiers give vision? I think they give some vision, but not full vision. So I don't know if he would have seen me there. I want to get this skull crab, though. There it is. I'm going to split this top... Split push this top wave here. Might as well smite this. Alright, so they put a banner minion up here, which is actually hard for some people to deal with, but not for Shaco. Basically, if you do magic damage, it's hard, but if not, you don't have to worry about it. My team is getting engaged on here. So do I want to join them? Because I'm actually quite strong, I can join them here. Because I can still run at the back line and assassinate people. But if they're all grouped up, it makes it a little bit more tricky. But I can still, like with some good positioning, I can still get in the back line. And with my Moby boots as well, I can travel. Like, I'm in the middle of the team right here before they even realize it. How the hell did that hit me? Legit, how did that Azir ult even hit me? It's bullshit, man. Oh, I didn't press ignite either, that's awkward. Oh my god. Am I reported? I should be. I'm alive though. Reported or alive, I'll take it, man. Alright. Well, I'm not alive anymore, but you know. I actually mucked that up pretty hard there. But yeah, Berserker Greaves are a good choice if you're team fighting a lot. Because Berserker Greaves actually give you ridiculous stats. They're really gold efficient for the attack speed they give you. I honestly think that Cho'Gath should just be trying to kill Lulu here. He shouldn't be trying to save Soraka. He could probably just have killed Lulu, honestly. That's fine. What was that? Like a 4-for-3 in the end in their favour? So we're going to have to do some really cheeky strategies here. Which is going to involve a sneaking Baron. Alright, so we're going to respawn a sneak Baron. I'm calling it right here. I'll go Elixir of Wrath as well for this play. Don't jump over the wall just yet though, mate. Is it warded? I'll put my sweeper and I'll jump in. If it's warded, then we don't do it. Okay. Okay, good. It's not warded anymore. No. Alright, so we should be able to do this pretty fast here. I just don't want my clone to die. He's gonna die, okay, but that's fine. Because we're gonna get it anyway. There we go. I called it, man. I said we're gonna do something cheeky. I mismanaged my clone pretty hard there, but still. We're so fortunate that ward died, like, the second we jumped in. But also, this is something which tilts me a little bit. I died like this on my main account playing Blitzcrank. Earlier. Blue ward, like, attacking blue wards actually pops your Moby boots. Going for wards isn't meant to pop Moby boots. Not anymore. Like, it used to, but not anymore. So we either just all push mid here, or I go bot and try and get this tower. Oh god, that could be it for us. Nice. Do I want to jump in here? I don't know, but I'm doing it anyway. Okay, I seem to be the only one doing this, but that's fine, because he's dead. And oh my goodness, yo, I would have survived that. My Q just came up, I almost had that. Honestly, I don't really feel like we needed to bait me that hard. Three of us are all in full health, including our AD carry and an endless healer. I do feel like I got baited a little bit there. I do feel a little bit disgruntled about that, but it's alright, it works out in the end, so it's okay, I guess. Like, we still get the tower, we kill... was it Azir we killed there? Like, I guess, like, honestly, like, playing Shaco, you can sacrifice yourself like this, and it's really not that bad. The only reason it wouldn't be worth it is if, you know... is if I'm really... well, as fed as I am. Like, I don't think that was a particularly good play, but it's not a bad play by itself. Like, the results aren't poor for us, because it means we kill Azir, who's, like, probably their best wave clear on their team, so we can push the tower down really easily. Having said that, I do think we probably would have got the tower anyway, and like I say, trading my life for his is a bit questionable when I'm so strong. But, you know what? Nichon does mean nipple, because one of the chat lines I learned was Savate Nichon. Savate Nichon? Actually, well, firstly, all of your chat lines in French have to start with Ebebe. Ebebe. That's how they start. Ebebe. Ebebe means, in case you're wondering what Ebebe means, Ebebe means hey baby. So there's that. If just because I know that sounds quite complicated, Ebebe. You not, might not know what that means. But yeah, Savatinishon, Ebebe. Savatinishon. That means hey baby. How are your nipples? That's a good chat line that I learned. That one's never failed on me, but then again, I've never used it, so, you know, but still, I'll take it. All right, do I want to jump in here? Not really. I want to go for GA as my next item, by the way. Oh my goodness, why are you running that way? Run towards me. All right. That's zero ult down. So there's no Azir for this fight. Oh my goodness. Yo, if I jumped into their enemy team here, that would have been so juicy. Shit, I failed. Oh my goodness, what is that shield? Yo, I could have done this so much better. That was such a good bait. Karma used her flash. They all jumped in. I should have done that, man. I should have jumped in. I was a pussy. I'm actually going to go top here and try and push this down. Yeah, I failed that pretty hard. Ah, in hindsight, man, that would have been such a delicious play. I would have insta-gibbed Karma and Ezreal, for sure. We probably would have won off that play, honestly. But yeah, I took a zero out of the fight there, so that helps. But we were kind of caught again, so... Oh, wait, this isn't a proper tower. This isn't a Azir tower. Okay, never mind. I'm an idiot. Just going to block off some, like, escape paths from me here. So if they get, like... If they try and collapse on me, I'll at least be able to stop it. But again, I go top and like four people follow, so that's good. I'm going to keep the pressure on here. Even though Soraka's recalling, she's got TP and she's also got her ultimate, so she'll still be able to influence this a little bit. Usually having vision is quite an important thing when you're split pushing, but... I don't need vision. If I know where they are, I don't need vision. And I know where these guys are right now, so I don't need the vision. I'm going to put another box down here. Again, like if these guys try to collapse onto me from this side, then I'm going to be able to stop it because I'm going to know... Like, these boxes are going to be able to stop them. And they're going to help me. I do want to recall soon, though, because I do have a fair amount of gold to spend. I'll get some... I'll finish my Triforce and then get GA. Alright, this is good as well. I'm going to be able to kill this Bannon. This Bannon has... Bannon? Banner of Command. Bannered cannon minion. Apparently, my head is now a Bannon minion. Fuck. So, Bannon... Oh, my goodness. Banner of Command minion... the Bannon cannon is a Bannon, apparently, but it has like a 3-minute cooldown, so I just take that and that's works fine for us. Just keep pushing. Now, I don't want my team to come with me here because I'm not really dedicating to this push. I'm just pushing it down. I'm really just being an annoying asshole here. And again, having boxes to help for my escape routes. Having more CDR would help me be able to put more boxes down, but it's okay. So they've rotated over. There's all five of them in mid right now. And as that bot wave pushes up, I'm going to push this one in as well. So we've basically got three waves pushing here because we've got our mid inhibitor down. I'm pushing top, and we're also pushing bot together. So stop pushing mid, man, and go bot. What are you doing? Don't solo push a lane of support. Like, there's two people in top here. There's two people in top here. And we're all... Meanwhile, we're just pushing bot. Why is he... I'm going to spam ping this guy. I'm going to spam ping him, man. Because I don't know why he's solo... Okay, I need to start... Okay, let's go with team, please. What is he doing? He can get a catch with his team as well. God damn it, Blitzcrank. Oh shit, this is warded. I'll get rid of this thing. It's a good ward, actually, for them. Okay, now that I'm coming mid, he's leaving? What the hell, man? This guy is drunk. What the fuck? What the hell is this guy on? Jesus. I'll just get this in here. Fuck it. No, if I'm here, do we win this fight? No. So I'll just get the inhib. I might be able to get a Nexus Tower here as well, actually. An enemy I'm probably gonna die, actually. Oh my goodness. Be free, Shaco. If I can run down here and draw them away from Baron, they might not be able... Oh, okay. Might not be able to get it. Okay. I was a little too over-eager there on that push, but I got the inhibitor, which is okay. The problem is as well that I didn't have a minion wave top for me to work with there. If we have Baron though, it will make it really easy for us to do these plays. But I've got my GA and my Triforce here, so I'm pretty strong. Triforce is actually going to be really good for me to one shot people. Even if... Okay, let's say he isn't trolling. It's fine, guys. Let's just focus. Even if he were trolling, us flaming him won't help. So I'm trying to keep the team spirits up here a little bit. Yo, these guys need to be careful here. I'm not actually here. I just respawned. Cho'Gath is slowly becoming really useless as well. We might lose this one. GG, les noobs. Yep, told you it was French. Well, because Ez isn't even low on health, there's no point in me going in on that. Like, suiciding for karma? Is that worth it? No. Well, they might go for Baron here. If they go for Baron, I may be able to steal it. Don't know where everyone else is, though. Where do they go? I think there's actually a ward around here. Oh god, he's got flash. Fuck. Oh my god, are you serious, man? That's so unfortunate. Yo, that's so unlucky. What the fuck, man? Look at that health bar. Come on, bro. Alright, so we get summoners out of Ezra there. He had all of his summoners up. I wasted my GA as well. Actually, I'm going to keep it. Still a good item for me to have here. Alright, so this game is going to be kind of hard. Like, this is what I said, by the way, in the early game. It's hard to, like, solo carry as Shaco. Because, yeah, I don't know, you just can't really solo carry. So, it's, you can try and split push and stuff, but at the end of the day, you can't do it all yourself. Although, having said that, if I had an assassin build this game, it might be a bit different. Well, I don't know, actually. There's been times where I've survived really low because of this build. Well, there are pros and cons, obviously. In that specific situation, it would have been better for us assassin because Ez would have died for sure. We do have damage for Volibear, yo. I already carry can deal with Volibear. He's got the Last Whisper. On volley, then we can get Ez easy and win that way. Oh god, are we getting caught? No. Okay, good. So I think I'm going to start grouping a little bit. Maybe I should actually just be split pushing. I don't know, actually. If Azir, like, pops this tower here, it's going to be really bad for me because I can't flank. As long as we can defend the tower here, which we are doing right now, that's fine. It's fine, just defend the tower. Blitzcrank's got 40% CDR. We'll just try and wait for him to hook. They're going bot. We can leave that tower there. Like, we can lose that bot, that's fine. Do I want to just split top though? That's the question. Like, losing this tower here is alright, it's not a big deal. Why do we have two mid though? Oh wait, we had this one off as well? Holy moly, okay. So, I'm making the decision here to stay, because I think that we can defend as a team. And I think that I can go into a position where I might be able to flank and just kill Ez or something. Alright, that's it, I'm going in. Alright, at least I got Azir, I guess. I got Azir and completely zoned Ez out of that fight. If this Triss position's a little better here. Yo, he just jumped in. Just get him, get him, get him. Yo, oh my goodness, man. He just jumped into everyone. What's he doing? How have we not killed him either? Oh, man. That was it. That was the key for that was the key to victory right there. Crap. I'm going to go for Berserker Greaves, though. I need the overall boost to DPS. Damn, that's a real shame. Ez completely threw the fight like that, like legit. Oh god. Alright. I think we should have been able to win that fight, to be honest. Ez jumped in and pretty much suicided, but we were too afraid. A little bit of impatience there on that one. I might be able to defend this, although Volibear looks like he's just ending the game. Yeah, this game's over. I want to try and kill someone. Come on, Volley, let me try and kill someone. No, that's rude. Alright. I think, to take away from that game, the thing is, I was pretty hard carrying that game, but like I say, it is difficult to hard carry on Shaco. I'm just trying to think, I think I'm trying to think about whenever you lose a game, what I'm gonna do here is because these videos are meant to teach you how to win games and how to carry. If I lose them, then there's got to be some kind of takeaway, else it's kind of pointless, right? Firstly, losing is part of climbing. If I play a game and I'm playing Shaco and I get that many kills in the early game and I make good calls for the Baron and I set up good split pushes and I assassinate people in fights, you're gonna win more games than you're gonna lose. So for starters, don't tilt. Okay, that's the first takeaway from this. Don't tilt, because if you start tilting in games like these, then you just ruin your chances in the future. It doesn't matter. No one gets to whatever elo they want to be at with 100% win rate. It doesn't happen, because you do lose games. So that's first thing. But secondly, you should also use these opportunities to reflect a little bit about what went wrong and that kind of stuff, because I can say that I deserved, I can say that I played well enough that I would win the majority of games like this, which I do believe would happen. But that doesn't mean that I played perfectly and I didn't play perfectly. So ironing out the mistakes from what you make is important as well. So just thinking about it now, I'm thinking the biggest takeaways of the stuff that I did poorly here was, I think maybe I should have dedicated more to team fights at times as well instead of split pushing. There were certain split pushes which maybe were just poor ideas, because I think I should have respected that they were just engaged quite hard with Lulu Karma Volibear combo. It's quite a hard engage combo, so maybe I should have respected that a bit more at times as well, specifically when we were quite ahead and we didn't have Baron, so setting up a split push was a bit difficult, so maybe I shouldn't have done that. I also had a few dumb deaths, so apart from some dumb deaths and probably grouping up a bit more, I think those are the two biggest things that would have helped me win the game then. But outside of that, our team comp was really bad for late game. We have two supports. We've got Blitzcrank and Striker as supports. We're not going to be able to do much with that. And Cho'Gath falls off really hard the later the game goes on, because Cho'Gath is really tanky in the mid game just because of his passive. But the later the game goes on, the more damage that enemy players have, specifically enemy AD carries, Cho'Gath just melts a little bit too fast. And he also stops being able to one shot people, because other people get tankier or whatever, people's shields get higher, and Cho'Gath can't rely on his base stats as much. I think that was kind of the biggest two things. But also, you don't just want to be negative about it. So the things that I did well here, this game, I think I did some good calls. That Baron call was quite good. I controlled Dragon quite well. I got a lot of ganks off. I was applying a lot of pressure in the lane phase, counter jungling quite a lot as well. So I think I did some good things. Overall, I played fairly well. Just some things to tweak, obviously, to maybe turn these games into victories. But bottom line is, don't tilt really hard. That's the most important lesson, because you'll win the majority of games if you feel like you're playing really well and you can influence games like happened in this one. So if you did like this video, feel free to give it a thumbs up. You can subscribe to me for more educational content. You can find me on Facebook and Twitter, streaming twitch.tv/foxshop. Most importantly, sorry I couldn't win out. Bring out the victory, but most importantly, thanks so much for watching, guys. Have a great day, and I will see you in my next video.